Hello everyone. So in this module, we are going to discuss how to obtain the Bode plot for a given transfer function, right? And how to check the stability of closed loop system, right? So we are already seeing what are the different frequency domain specifications. And we have also discussed that for a system to be stable, both the gain margin and the phase margin has to be positive, okay? So in this module, we will try to draw the Bode plot for one or two transfer functions. See how we can read the gain margin and the phase margin from the semi-log graph sheets. Okay. So consider this question. Check the closed loop stability. Check the closed loop stability using Bode plots. Using Bode plots whose open loop transfer function is GSHS equals 100 divided by s into s plus 1 into s plus 2. Okay. Check the closed loop stability using Bode plot whose open loop transfer function is GSHS equals 100 divided by s into s plus 1 into s plus 2. Okay. So what's the first step? We have to obtain the sinusoidal transfer function. Okay. So GG omega, HG omega. Wherever you find S, replace S with J omega. So you will get 100 divided by J omega into J omega plus 1 into J omega plus 2. Okay. Now, before we proceed further, we have to make sure that all the factors are in 1 plus ST form. Okay. So J omega plus 1 is in the 1 plus J omega T or 1 plus ST form. But this is not in 1 plus form. So you have to take 2 outside of this thing. So this 102 gets cancelled, it becomes 50 divided by j omega into 1 plus j omega into 1 plus j omega by 2. Okay. So this 2 is the corner frequency here, and here the corner frequency is 1. So this will be the sinusoidal transfer function. Okay. Now what next? We have to find the magnitude in decibels and plot it against omega in logarithmic scale. Similarly, we have to find what's the angle and then plot it against log omega. Okay. So the next step is to obtain the dB gain. Fine. So what we will do is that we will obtain the overall Bode plot in one shot, in one go. Most of the books, what they do is that they will plot the Bode plot for each factor individually, and then they will add it up to obtain the final overall Bode magnitude plot. Okay. But we will do some simple calculation with which in one go we can calculate the overall Bode magnitude plot in asymptotic form. Asymptotes means straight lines. Okay. So when you are drawing it with hand, we can do only asymptotic plots or straight line Bode plots. But if you are doing it with MATLAB, then MATLAB will give you the actual curvish plots. Okay. So what we have to do is that we have to now create a table. We have to construct a table whose first entry is factor. Okay, first column is factor. Next column must be corner frequency. What's the unit of corner frequency? Radians per second, omega. Okay, radians per second. Then comes the individual slope. Unit of slope, dB per decade. And finally, we have the certain slope. Okay. Now what next? We have to enter each factor in such a way that the corner frequencies are in ascending order. They are in increasing order. Okay. you have to render each factor in such a way that the corner frequencies are in increasing order. Okay. So if you see here, we have 50 by j omega into 1 plus j omega into 1 plus j omega by 2. So what's the corner frequency of 50? There's no corner frequency. dB magnitude gain plot will be 20 log 50. Okay. Now coming to 1 by j omega, what's the corner frequency? It doesn't have a corner frequency. From low frequency to high frequency, right? It is a straight line with a constant slope of minus 20 dB per decade. There is no corner frequency for 1 by j omega. Okay, so that means 50 by j omega can be chosen as the first factor. 50 by j omega. 50 divided by j omega. So there is no corner frequency. What is the increasing slope? Slope of 50 is 0 dB because it will be a straight line parallel to the x-axis. 20 log 50, right? What will the slope of 1 by j omega? Minus 20 dB per decade. So the net slope of 50 by j omega will be minus 20 dB per decade. Always, the first resultant slope is the same as the first individual slope. So this is minus 20 here. I will write it here, minus 20. First factor is done with. Okay. Now what should be the next factor? Keep in mind, factors are to be entered in such a way that corner frequencies are in increasing order. So the next, here the corner frequency is 1, here the corner frequency is 2. So naturally, the next factor will be 1 by 1 plus j omega. Corner frequency is 1. What is the increasing slope? Minus 20. And what will be the resultant slope? The resultant slope is given by present individual slope plus the previous resultant slope. That means minus 20 plus minus 20 minus 40. Right? So second factor is done with. Now we are left out with the third factor and the third and the final factor. And that is 1 by 1 plus j omega by 2. What's the corner frequency? 2. What's the individual slope? Minus 20. And what will be the resistance slope? Tell me, what will be the resistance slope? Present individual slope plus the previous resistance slope. That means minus 40 minus 20, which is nothing but minus 60. Okay, so we have completed the table that we need to have with us for creating the dB magnitude plot, right? Now what next? So here you can see the least corner frequency in this problem is 1. Okay, so whenever you plot a border plot in semi-log graph sheet using pencil and ruler, we have to take minimum 1 dB behind the least corner frequency. So what will be 1 dB minimum? What will be 1 dB behind the least corner frequency? 1, it will be 0.1, because 0.1 into 10 is 1. Okay, decade means factor of 10, right? So 1 decade behind 1 means it should start from 0.1. Okay, so our starting point is log 1. Starting point. We know to plot a straight line, we need minimum 2 endpoints, right? X1, Y1 and X2, Y2, okay? So this is the starting point, X1, Y1. What will be that, X1, Y1? So we have fixed that our scale should start from 0.1. So our X1 will be log 0.1. Now, what about Y? In the Y-axis, we have dB gain, okay? So what will be the dB gain? What should be the dB gain here? It should be 20 log 50 by omega. Because first factor is 50 by j omega. So magnitude of 50 by j omega will be 50 by omega. And decibels, it will be 20 log 50 by omega. So since we are starting omega from 0.1, the starting y1 will be 20 log 50 by 0.1. Okay? 20 log 50 by 0.1. Suppose you started your frequency from 0.01. Then what would have been the corresponding Y1, the dB gain? It would have been 20 log 50 divided by 0.01. Fine. So if you do this calculation, you will see your X1, Y1 will be log 0.1, 53.9794. Fine. Now what next? So this is the starting point. Now, so 1, 2, these are called corner frequencies. And we have seen that at corner frequency, slope changes. Okay. So you have to visualize that in mind. So 50 by j omega means from low frequency to high frequency, stop is minus 20 dB per decade. But up to what value? Up to corner frequency 1. Okay, because at 1, the slope changes from minus 20 to minus 40. Okay, so from low frequency to corner frequency 1, the slope is minus 20 dB per decade, right? And from 1 to 2, the slope will be minus 40 dB per decade. And from 2 to high frequencies, the slope will be minus 60 dB per decade. Okay, so starting point we have taken as 0.1. So from 0.1 to 1, the slope should be minus 20. So m is the slope, m is minus 20 dB per decade. Right? Now what is x2? x2 by 2. x2 we know from the table, our x2 will be log 1. Okay? Log 1 comma y2. Right? Now we have to solve for y2. How? y2 minus y1 by x2 minus h1 is m. Okay? We know what is y1 from here. We know what is x2 from here. We know what is x1 and we know what is m. So the only unknown is y2. If you solve this, you will get log 1 comma 33.9794 dB. That will be our x2 y2. Okay? Now, from 1 to 2, what is the resultant slope? It is minus 40 dB per decade. Okay? So, slope is minus 40 dB per decade. M is minus 40 dB per decade. So, what is my x3, y3 now? x3 will be, from the table you will get, what is x3? x3 will be 2. Okay, so log 2. x3 is log 2. And the unknown value is y3, which has to be solved for. So, if you solve for that, you will get log 2 comma y3 will be 21.9382 decibels. Fine. So that will be our y3, x3 y3, right? x3 y3 is log 2 comma 21.9382. Fine. Then from 2 to infinity, what's the slope? Slope is minus 60 dB per decade. Okay. From 2 to infinity, slope is minus 60 dB per decade. Correct? So that means you can take any value of frequency higher than 2. Right? Higher than 2, you can take any frequency. Right? For convenience, I will take 10 because I know log 10 is 1. That's the only reason. You can take log 50, you can take 100, you can take log 1000, any value you can take. Okay? Just for convenience, I will take my x4 as log 10. So what is the slope now? Slope m is minus 60. Now the slope is minus 60 dB per decade. So x4, I will choose x4 as log 10 comma y4. Okay. So if you follow the same strategy, upon solving, you will get your x4 y4 as log 10 comma minus 20. Okay. So we have completed the data required for constructing the asymptotic magnitude plot. Okay. Now how will you do this? So we have to consider SNE log graph sheet. Right? So this is what is shown here, SNE log graph sheet. Okay, so this is the SNE log graph sheet. Okay. So as you can see here, x-axis is not linear and uniform. It is in logarithmic scale. That is why initially you have the scale is expanded and eventually it gets shrunk. It gets crowded. Okay. So this is one cycle. So there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 cycles are there. Okay. 6 cycles are here. They are in this, available in this present semi-log graph sheet. Right. So we have decided that our scale should start from 0.1. Fine. Scale should start from 0.1. So if I mark this as 0.1, what will be the next main line? It will be 0.1 into 10. 1. Next one will be what? 1 into 10. 10. Next one will be 100. 1000. 10,000. and so on. So a wide range of frequencies can be represented. Okay, frequency response data for a wide range of frequencies can be represented in a semi-log graph sheet. Fine. Now, what is our first point? So now we have to fix the scale for y-axis. Okay, if you see our y-axis, the upper range is 53.97 corresponding to x1. Okay, so let us fix that the upper limit as 60 dB. Okay, so here we have the dB in y-axis. Here we are having the dB gain. Okay, so this is 60 dB, say this is 40, this is 20, this is 0, this is minus 20, and this is minus 40. Okay, so this is my 0 dB line, omega. Okay, this is my 0 dB line. Okay, now what is x1 y1 log 0.1 comma 53.9? That means 54 I will take. Okay, so log 0.1 comma 54, where is that? So this should be 52 54. Okay, log 0.1 comma 54. What is x2 y2? Log 1 comma 33.97. I will take it as 34. Okay, so log 1 comma 34. This is log 1. What is 34? This is 30. 34 is somewhere here. Okay, then x3 y3 is log 2 comma 21.9. So 22 I will take. Okay, log 2 comma 22. So if this is 1, this is 2, 3, 4, and so on. This is 10, 20, 30, etc. Okay, so log 2 comma 22. Log 2 comma 22. So 22 will be somewhere here, right? 22. Right, then what is x4 y4? It is nothing but log 10 comma minus 20. Log 10 is here and this is minus 20. Okay, now what we have to do, we have to take a ruler and just join the points sequentially. Okay, so anyway, I don't have a ruler right now, so just to show you, I will draw a line. Okay, so it should be a straight line. Even though we had calculated only up to log 10 from 2 to infinity, the slope is minus 60 dB per decade. Okay, so this is minus 20 dB per decade. This is minus 40 dB per decade. And this is minus 60 dB per decade. Okay, minus 60 dB per decade. So what is this point? This point is my x1 y1. Okay, this is x2 y2. I have already calculated. This is x3 y3. Right? And this is x4 y4. Okay, so after x3, it can be extended up to maximum possible limit. Okay, because from 2 to infinity, the slope is minus 60 dB per decade. Okay, so we are done with the magnitude plot. Okay, so this is your 0 dB line. Don't forget, this is our 0 dB line. Okay, now what next we have to do? We have to plot the angle part. Okay, so how can we plot the angle part? For that, we have to again create a table. Okay, so what will be the table combines? First one will be omega. First column will be omega. Okay. Now, before that, what is our transfer function? Our transfer function is 100 divided by this thing, right? So 50 divided by this. J omega into, what will be the net angle here? Let me calculate. Minus 90 minus tan inverse omega minus tan inverse omega by 2. Agree? Minus 90 minus tan inverse omega minus tan inverse omega by 2. Okay, so our table for constructing the phase angle plot consists of three parts, or four columns rather. first column is omega, then minus 90 degree, that is independent of frequency, okay? Then minus tan inverse omega, then minus tan inverse omega by 2, and finally angle gj omega, hj omega. Okay, now you see our scale started from 0.1. So from 0.1 up to maximum you can change. Okay, so when omega is 0.1, there will be minus 90 degree. What is minus tan inverse omega? That is minus 5.71. What will be minus tan inverse omega by 2? That will be minus 2.86. So you just add these three. You will get the net angle as minus 98.57 degree, corresponding to a frequency of 0.1. So like that, you have to take many points. Okay, 0.1, 0.2, 0.5, like that, many points you have to take, as many points as possible. Okay, so you add the corresponding values at each row. Okay, so the last column will give you the net angle corresponding to each of this frequency. Okay, so once you have obtained that, you can fix your axis for a scale for y axis here for the angle part. Say for example, so here it starts with minus 98. Okay, so rather say 0 degree. Right, then so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Right, so 0 degree, that means one, maybe this can be minus 30. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so this can be minus 45. Okay, minus 45. This is minus 90. This is minus 135. This is minus 180, and this is minus degree. Okay, so now 0.1. When omega was 0.1, we have calculated what is the angle. It is minus 98.57. So 0.1 minus 98.57 will be somewhere here. Somewhere here. Okay, you just find where's the actual point and do that. Okay, so like that, you try to plot all the points. You have to do the calculation part, okay? I will just draw some sample representative points. Some curve. It is not the actual curve. You have to plot for, you have to calculate what will be the angle for different values of omega, plot it on exactly, and then join it with the freehand sketch. Okay? Join angle plot is a freehand sketch only after obtaining the sufficient number of points. Okay? So this is just some sample. Okay, I didn't calculate the all angle points at different frequencies. Okay, so assume that these are all some angle points I have calculated. Okay, so let it be some sample. Okay, now what next? We have to, how will you calculate the gain margin, phase margin? What is gain margin, phase margin? Gain margin is nothing but the factor by which the open loop gain is to be multiplied at omega pc. What is omega pc? Phase crossover frequency. Now comes the question, what do you mean by phase crossover frequency? Okay, phase crossover frequency means frequency at which the phase angle becomes equal to minus 180. That means here in this particular case, you see that where it crosses the minus 180 degree line. So at this frequency, assume this is the frequency. Okay, assume that this is the frequency at which it cuts the minus 180 degree line. Okay, so the corresponding value. Okay, so this will be your omega pc. Okay, and that will be 200 300 400. Okay, its actual value is something else, right? This I am just doing a sample representation just to let you know how we can read gain margin and phase margin from that given Bode plot. Okay, you have to draw the actual plot on the semi-dog graph sheet and measure that. This is how to measure that. Okay, so first you identify what is your omega pc. Omega pc means frequency at which the angle, open loop angle, gj omega, hj omega becomes equal to minus 180 degree. Okay? If you extend that line to the upwards, you will see that it as per this figure, you are getting 200, 300, 400. Okay, of course, that's not the value, it is very less, around 4 point something, I think. If you do some calculation, you will see that. Okay. So omega PC you have found, right? Now what you have to do? So let my magnitude plot be something like this. Okay. Let my magnitude plot be something like this. Something like this, okay? Not this. Okay. So my magnitude plot is something like this. Okay. Now what happens? Now what you have to do is that you measure. Yeah, you have. So this is your omega PC, right? So you measure the difference between 0 dB line and the point at which it cuts the dB gain plot. Okay. Keep in mind, this frequency is the phase Poisson frequency, right? So the line will cut the dB gain at this point. How much difference is there from that vertical difference is there from that particular point to 0 dB line? This was our 0 dB line. Okay. So this is what is called gain margin. Okay. Now coming to phase margin. What is phase margin? Phase margin is the additional phase lag that is to be added. Okay. The additional phase lag that is to be added at gain crossover frequency. Now comes the question, what is gain crossover frequency? So gain crossover frequency means frequency at which the dB gain becomes zero. So at what frequency it becomes zero? Say somewhere at this point. Okay. Somewhere at that point, the gain becomes 0 dB. This is the 0 dB line. Okay. So the gain cuts the 0 dB line at say this point. Okay. So now what you have to do? You have to draw a vertical line from there up to the gain onto the phase angle plot. Okay. So it will hit the phase angle plot at this point, right? Now you measure how much is the difference between minus 180 degree line and that thing. That means this much. Okay. So what did you do? What did I do? I first computed what is my omega GC. Okay. Omega GC means gain crossover frequency. Gain crossover frequency. That is frequency at which dB gain equals zero. Okay, that is what we mean by gain crossover frequency. And what is omega PC, phase crossover frequency? That means phase crossover frequency. Okay, so that means frequency at which angle GJ omega, HJ omega, PC, GJ omega, HJ omega becomes equal to plus or minus 180 degree. Okay, plus or minus 180 degree. Fine. So, how to read phase margin from the Bode plot? You first obtain omega GC, drop a line to the phase angle plot, measure the vertical difference between that particular point on the phase angle plot and minus 180 degree line. Okay, that will give you phase margin. So this is how to read the gain margin and phase margin from Bode plots. Okay, so I would suggest you substitute different values for omega, right? Calculate what are the actual angle values. Just do a one-to-one plotting between these frequencies and the net angle. Okay, so you will get the exact shape of the curve, phase angle curve. Fine. Now this is how to read the gain margin and phase margin from Bode plot. Now how can we calculate that? Is it possible to calculate that? Yes, it is possible. How to do that? That is the next step. Okay. So transfer function was GJ omega, HJ omega. What was that? 50 divided by J omega into 1 plus J omega into 1 plus J omega by 2. Okay. What is gain crossover frequency? frequency at which gain is equal to 0 dB or gain is equal to 1, because we know 20 log 1 is 0. Okay, so to find omega GC, what you have to do, equate the magnitude to 1. So mod GJ omega GC HJ omega GC equal to 1. So what's the magnitude? It is 50 divided by omega into root of 1 plus omega square into root of 1 plus omega square by 4 must be equal to 1. It's omega GC. That is what is gain cross of frequency. So if you solve this equation, you will get your omega GC as gain cross of frequency as 4.4657 radians per second. Okay, this will be the gain cross of frequency. Right? If you do the actual Bode plot, in and around 4.46 or 4.5, you will get omega GC. You can read that value from the Bode plot if your Bode plot is correct. Okay, like if you do it graphically with hand, then you will get close to 4.46 value. Okay, it will not be precisely this thing. Sometimes it will be different depending upon the accuracy of your pencil thickness and so on. Okay. Now what next? We have to find what is phase margin. So what is phase margin? Its margin is, we have seen, phase margin is nothing but 180 plus angle GJ omega HJ omega. Okay, this is our phase margin. Right? Phase margin is 180 plus angle GJ omega HJ omega. Angle GJ omega. At what frequency? At gain crossover frequency. That is must. Okay. That is defined only for gain crossover frequency. At GJ omega C HJ omega C. Okay, now what will be that? 180 plus. What is the net angle here? Net angle will be minus 90 minus tan inverse omega minus tan inverse omega by 2. Okay, so you can write here minus 90 minus tan inverse omega GC minus tan inverse omega GC by 2. Omega GC value we found 4.4657. Okay, our omega GC was, we found it, found that 4.4657. Substitute that here. What will be the value? You will get the phase angle, the angle phase margin, the total phase margin as minus 53.52 degrees. Okay, minus 53.52 degrees. Now what next? We have to calculate what is gain margin. So gain margin is found at phase crossover frequency. So next we have to calculate what will be the phase crossover frequency. To find omega PC. What is omega PC? Frequency at which angle GJ omega HJ omega becomes equal to 180 or minus 180. Okay. So angle GJ omega PC HJ omega PC will be equal to minus 180. So angle we know, that is nothing but minus 90 minus tan inverse omega PC minus tan inverse omega PC by 2 must be equal to minus 180. How can you solve this? You bring this minus 180 to left side and take the tan terms to the right side. So you will get tan inverse omega PC plus tan inverse omega PC by 2 equals 90. Okay, how will you solve this? Tan A plus B. What is tan A plus B? Tan A plus B is tan A plus tan B divided by 1 minus tan A tan B. Okay, so if you apply that, you will get omega PC plus omega PC by 2 all by 1 minus omega PC square by 2 equal to infinity, which means what? 1 minus omega PC square by 2 equal to 0, or your omega PC will be root 2, which is nothing but 1.4142 radians per second. This is my phase crossover frequency. Okay, This is my phase cosine frequency. Did we complete? No. Our aim is to find what is gain margin. Now, how can we find the gain margin? Gain margin is given by 1 divided reciprocal of the open loop magnitude at the phase crossover frequency. Okay, it is the reciprocal of the open loop magnitude at phase crossover frequency. Okay, so how can we find gain margin here? Our gain margin will be 1 by mod gj omega tc h j omega tc. Okay. What is gj omega pc, hj omega pc magnitude? 50 divided by this thing. So reciprocal of that means what? Reciprocal of that means omega gc into, okay, reciprocal of that means omega pc into root of 1 plus omega pc square into root of 1 plus omega pc square by 4 whole divided by 50. Okay, if you do this, what will you get? You will get the value as 0.06. What is 0.06? It is that factor. So when we discuss the gain margin definition, it is the factor by which the open loop gain is to be multiplied at omega pc. That's what we got. Okay, that's what we got as 0.06. How will you find the gain decibels? 20 log 0.06. That means minus 24.4369 dB. Okay. So gain margin is negative. Phase margin is also a negative. So what can you say about system stability? The system is unstable. Okay. Because we had seen here, for a system to be stable, both the gain margin and the phase margin has to be positive. Okay, both the gain margin and the phase margin has to be positive. In this particular case, both the gain margin means gain margin decibel, that's the meaning. Okay, otherwise you have got some factor 0.06 or 0.02, that's what you got. Okay, so your gain margin must be positive means gain margin in decibels. Okay, so in this particular problem, the gain margin in decibels and the phase margin both are negative. So the closed loop system will be unstable, fine. So that is what you get when you do this thing, when you do the analysis using Bode plot like this. Okay, so from Bode plot also you get the same thing, right? So we have calculated the gain margin as minus 24.4. What is 1.41? That is the phase crossover frequency, because gain margin is found at phase crossover frequency. Now, what's the phase margin? We calculated that as minus 53.52 degree, right? And that is found at gain crossover frequency. What is gain crossover frequency? 4.4657. Okay, so that is what MATLAB is also giving. So our calculation is correct. Okay, now. So we have just seen one example, okay? Now, in general, suppose this red line is asymptotic magnitude plot, okay? We have, when you draw it by hand, with hand, you can draw only asymptotic plot, okay? So this is a dB gain plot, and this is the phase angle plot, okay? What happens here? Here, this is, This is the omega pc, phase crossover frequency, and we are calculating what is gain margin. Okay, so from omega pc you drop a vertical upwards to the magnitude plot. The vertical difference between 0 dB line and that point is what is gain margin. So here, how can you find the gain margin? So this 0 dB, so this will be some negative dB. Okay, so what is the gain margin? 0 minus negative dB. So 0 minus negative dB means plus dB. So gain margin is positive. Right now. This is the omega gc, gain crossover frequency means what? At what frequency the dB gain becomes zero. So you drop a line, vertical line down until it hits the phase angle plot. Okay, vertical difference between that point and 180 degree line, that is what is phase margin. So here the phase margin is positive. So system is stable. Now you can see here that your omega PC is greater than that of omega GC. Okay. So for a stable system, omega GC should be less than omega PC, or omega PC phase cost of frequency must be greater than that of gain cost of frequency. Okay. Now, in this case, what happens? Omega GC is greater than omega PC. So naturally, the system is gain margin is negative and phase margin is also negative. So this is 0 dB line, 0 minus positive dB. So it will be negative gain margin. 0 minus, say, for example, it is say 5 dB. 0 minus 5 is minus 5. So gain margin is negative. Here, what happens? If you hit the line, if you hit the phase angle plot below the 180 degree line. Okay. So gain phase margin will become negative. Okay. So for unstable systems, always omega GC will be greater than omega PC. What happens if omega GC and omega PC are equal? What happens? Any idea? Suppose these omega GC and omega PC are equal, right? It cuts the 0 dB line at omega GC. It cuts the minus 180 degree line at omega GC value. Same frequency. What happens? The system will be marginally stable, right? So that means gain margin will be 0 and phase margin will also be 0 dB. Okay? So you cannot add any gain at gain cost of frequency. And you cannot add any gain at phase cost of frequency, and you cannot add any angle at gain cost of frequency. Okay, so that means the closed loop system is marginally stable, right? So let us take two examples, or you can try it as a homework. Gj omega Hj omega equals, you are given Gj omega Hj omega equals K divided by J omega into 1 plus J omega whole square. Okay. So you have to find what, check the stability. Okay. Check for omega GC, gain cost of frequency, phase cost of frequency, omega PC, gain margin, phase margin for A. And stability, okay, and stability for case A, K equal to 0.1. Case B, K equal to 2. And case C, K equal to 10. Okay, so I will give you the final answer. You can check it at home, okay, you can check it later. So when k equal to 0.1, your omega GC is 0.099. Okay, 0.099 radians per second. And phase margin will be 78.69 degrees. Okay, your omega, what is omega PC? Omega PC will be 1 radians per second. And what will be gain margin? Gain margin will be 20 or 26 dB. So this 26 means 20 log 20. Okay, 26 dB. So the gain margin decibel is positive, phase margin is also positive. So system is stable. Case 2, when k equal to 2. What will be omega PC? Omega PC will be same. That's not going to change. Okay. Omega PC will be same. Because that is independent of the gain. Okay. Angles determined only by the J omega factors. Okay. So omega PC is always 1 radians per second. That is known to us. Okay. So what will be omega GC? Omega GC will be, when k equal to 2, omega GC is 1 radians per second. So it is evident. Right now itself, you can conclude what? Since omega GC and omega PC are equal at 1 radians per second, system will be marginally stable. Marginally stable. Marginally Okay. Now what is phase margin? So gain margin will be, phase margin will be 0 degree, and gain margin will also be, so gain margin is 0 degree, and gain, phase margin is 0 degree, and gain margin is 0 degree. Okay. So in time domain, it means the close to poles are on the j omega axis. Okay. When the poles are on j omega axis, system is marginally stable. It corresponds to this case. You cannot add any gain and any phase to the closed loop system. Right? System becomes unstable if you add. Now, when k is equal to 10, what will you get? Your omega gc will be 2 radians per second. 2 radians per second. Phase margin is minus 36.86. Okay? Since phase margin is negative, now we can conclude the system will be unstable. Anyway, for completeness, let us calculate gain margin. And that turns out to be 0.2. Or 20 log 0.2 will be minus 13.97. So what can you say? What can you conclude about the closed loop stability? Closed loop system will be unstable. Okay. So we will stop here for the day. If you have any doubt, don't hesitate to get back to me. Okay. Thank you.